Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I'm DeMartez, Baton Rouge, Louisiana's homegrown source for entertainment news. And I'm also your brother, cousin, uncle, best friend, co-worker, castmate, neighbor, everything wrapped up into one. It's midweek Wednesday, February the 1st, 2012. It's the first of the month. Wake up, cash your checks and come on, cash those checks and bring them to me. Hope you're having a great day here in Baton Rouge. It's a rainy, rainy start to the day, so make sure you have your umbrella, raincoat, slicker suit, rain boots, whatever you need to definitely keep dry. This is the Midweek DeMartez Entertainment News Show. So on today's show, I'm going to tell you about Adele performing at the Grammys after surgery. I'm going to tell you about Snoop Dogg supporting Ron Paul. I'm going to tell you about singer D'Angelo. He's back, and he falls off stage. Also, reasons to give up drinking soda. Like, we all know soda's not good, but these are some really interesting reasons. And President Obama on American Idol? Yeah, I'll tell you more about that. I want to first say thank you so much to all of the listeners that listen to the show. Have to give a great thank you to the state of Louisiana, Texas, Georgia, Mississippi, Florida, North and South Carolina, California, and even New York. So thank you all so much. Spread the word about the DeMartez Show. Be sure, if you're on Twitter, follow me on Twitter. My handle is D_Martez. And I'm on Facebook. You can like my Facebook fan page. That's D.Martez. Okay, so I love when you guys email me. I really, really do. And I do read the emails. And this was an interesting email I received from one of your fellow listeners. I received an email and someone asked me, DeMartez, I never hear you talk about the Braxton Family Values show. Do you watch the show? And can Tamar really sing? Very interesting question. Yes, I do watch the Braxton show. I like it. I am a fan of Toni Braxton. And can Tamar sing? Now, we all know that Tamar is annoying.com, but yes, Tamar Braxton can sing. She can really hold it down. And it always brings me back to the Kingdom Come soundtrack from 2001. On the soundtrack, you have Jill Scott, Carl Thomas, Mary Mary. This album was produced and directed by Kirk Franklin, and Tamar Braxton has a song on this album called Try Me. So I'm going to play the song for you, and a lot of you may have never heard the song, may have never really heard Tamar sing, so like the head go, here's Tamar Braxton, Try Me. Even though you hurt me and sometimes forget my name, my love is unconditional. Tamar Braxton, Try Me. Didn't know Tamar could get that high, huh? Tamar says, try her. So again, that's from the Kingdom Come soundtrack, 2001, produced by Kirk Franklin. Hope that answered your question. If you have any questions or suggestions about the show or anything, email me, DeMartez@DeMartez.com. So, President Obama on American Idol, yes. Now, you know, earlier last month, there was a fundraiser at the Apollo Theater, and President Obama gave a brief sample of his singing ability when he did a rendition of the classic R&B song, Let's Stay Together by Al Green. Now, President Obama doing this rendition helped Al Green's sales skyrocket. And I mean, It's on YouTube, over 4 million views. And if you haven't heard President Obama sing Let's Stay Together, here it is, right here, on the DeMartez Midweek Entertainment News Show.
Reverend Al Green was here. So in love.
President Obama. So, the producers of American Idol want President Obama to be on the show. That's right. Now, a lot of you are like, okay, but why? Well, really, it's because American Idol's ratings for this season have been dog horrible, and they're looking at President Obama as a way to lift up the ratings. I mean, when someone has over 4 million views on YouTube, that means a lot of people are paying attention and they're watching them. So they're hoping that this could help raise the ratings. But if President Obama is going to be on Idol, it won't be until later in the season. So that will definitely be interesting. Adele set to perform at the Grammys after surgery. Now, Adele is nominated for 6 Grammys, and she plans to be there to win all 6. The 23-year-old singer is set to perform. She has not performed since she had surgery on her vocal cords last year, and that was 5 months. So it's been 5 months since she performed. Her latest album, 21, has sold more than 6 million copies in the U.S. It's nominated for Album of the Year and Best Pop Vocal Album. And of course, the big hit from the album is Rolling in the Deep. There's a fire burning in my heart. Yeah. I really like that song. I like that album. Hot, hot album. The Grammys will air February the 12th. In Los Angeles, and Mr. Licking Lips himself, LL Cool J, is set to host the Grammys. Snoop Dogg is supporting Ron Paul's stance on drugs. Not a surprise, we all know Snoop Dogg loves marijuana, and he is supporting, he's drawn to Ron Paul because Ron Paul is a co-sponsor of the States' Rights to Medical Marijuana Act, and Paul also supports the Personal Use of Marijuana by Responsible Adults Act of 2008. Hear me out, Snoop, Responsible Adults Act. So the Chicago Tribune reports that Snoop posted a picture of Ron Paul with the headline which read, "Smoke weed every day." And that's your thought for the day. No, but not a surprise coming from Snoop Dogg. D'Angelo, Mr. Shirtless, how does it feel, D'Angelo? Angie Stone's baby daddy. Well, he's trying to make a comeback after 10 years, but it seems that he's failing badly. The 37-year-old singer canceled his Amsterdam concert after falling off the stage before he even grabbed the mic. Now, the doors were supposed to open at 7 p.m. This is a source told this to the Boombox. There were a couple of hundred people waiting in line, but the doors didn't open till about 7:20. Okay, so they were already late. And then a few guys came out and told the crowd that D'Angelo had fallen from the stage last night and will not be performing tonight. So, of course, a reason to his fall has not been revealed. We don't know what happened. But, you know, I bet it has something to do with Angie Stone. He probably was on stage thinking, how did I have a baby for Angie Stone? No, let me stop. But the good thing, the concert has been rescheduled for February the 2nd. If I was there, I would have asked D'Angelo. You know, I would have been like, how does it feel? How does it feel to fall off the stage and look a mess? How does it feel? Your body's not what it used to be. How does it feel? Okay. Reasons to give up drinking soda. Now, we know soda's not good for us, but we like to drink it, right? You know, every once in a while, I get like this strong desire to have a Sprite, and I have it. But after recent study, I may not. So let me give you a few reasons to give up drinking soda. And some of you may not drink soda at all, or you may know some people that do, or you may casually, every once in a while, socially drink soda. But reasons to give it up. Well, soda is useless. First of all, there's no nutritional benefits in soda, and soft drinks mostly consist of filtered water and refined sugars. Check this out. Average American drinks about 57 gallons of soda each year. Okay, so it's useless. Weight gain and obesity. Many people either forget or don't realize how many extra calories they consume in what they drink. Drinking a single can of sugary beverage like soda translate to more than 1 pound of weight gain every month. Don't need that. Drinking soda also weakens bones and higher risk for osteoporosis. Yeah, frequent consumption of soft drinks may increase the risk of osteoporosis, especially in people who drink soft drinks instead of calcium-rich milk. And kidney damage. Research has clearly demonstrated that the large quantities of cola result is enhanced and it forms kidney stones. Okay, if you're wondering exactly how soft drinks cause kidney stones, it's because of their acidity and radical mineral imbalances. Your body must buffer the acidity of soft drinks with calcium from your bones. Wow. So there you have it, reasons to give up drinking soda. And we knew these, right? So, you know, just reach for water, tea, apple juice. Water's the best drink. But you know, water gets boring after you've put lemon in it and, you know, all of that. It's just water. It's boring. Okay. Well, that's it for the DeMartez Midweek Entertainment News Show. Remember, you can come to the site throughout the day, read the blogs, tell people about the show. Thanks for supporting me. I really appreciate it. Please click on the events tab on the site because you'll see some interesting events taking place right here in Baton Rouge, and I want to highlight one of them, and that's August Wilson's Fences. Yeah, a wonderful play that's going to be put on by New Venture Theater, local theater company right here in Baton Rouge. There's three performances, February 10th through the 12th. You can visit newventuretheater.com or just click that events tab right here on my site for more information. Well, I'm going to leave you now, but I'll return next week. But what am I listening to? Well, I'm listening to James Fortune's new CD. It's called Identity. If you don't know who James Fortune is, build up your gospel collection. He's a gospel artist. And he asked for Kim Burrell to help him out on this album. And she has a track on the album called With You. It's track number 14. This is James Fortune's latest CD, Identity. And I'll leave you with Kim Burrell singing. This is a singing woman. Have a great day. Remember, today's going to be the best day of your life. Something good will definitely happen to you. Believe that. Receive that. DeMartez, I love you listening.
God of love, God of power, the only reason that I'm still here. God of mercy, your hand of grace touched my life, I'm forever changed. Life was so empty until you came in. When I was weak, you showed me your strength. Now I'm convinced that I can do anything with you.